waiting unto his coming. And because God will not do anything mighty, anything spectacular, anything significant, cruel, sure, that is not holy. And that is why, as we come, a mighty army, God wants to make out of us and in us and with us holy people. Because it's holy people that can do holy exploits. Now I pray that God will find this holy, will find you holy in this end time in Jesus' name. And let me just recap a little to what we have said, because many of you were not here then, and I pray I will remember some of these things that I was even telling you then. If, may I even confide in you that some of the things I spoke to you, I didn't have them penned down with me now, and I could not even really believe my hand or many of, some of the records now that I even share with you. It was God speaking to you, and see it that way as well, that God was speaking to you, not man. And I got had an intention then to make somebody new, someone new, a woman, a new woman, a new man, a new man, a new woman, out of each and every one of us. I remember those first Saturdays ago, I started with what we call an environment of holiness. And I said then that the world we are in now, we are talking about environment as new area of study. Knowing fully well that what we give an environment is what we have. That's what they call ecosystem in science, am I right? And they talk about habitats. And we say that if you destroy the, you can destroy the ecosystem, you can destroy the environment, you can make the environment habitable for yourself. We are talking about global warmth now, because we say the ozonosphere has been depleted. And now the sun now is having more scorching effect on the inhabitants of the earth. Why? Because the world is giving out smokes and pollution. And then what we are giving the world, what we are giving the globe is giving now back unto us. The same way, if you give holiness unto the source, you can create an environment for your brother to be holy by your action, by your reaction, by your disposition, by your dressing, and by your deport, by your courage, by everything you do. You can make someone find it more easier to live holy. And if I create an environment for my brother to live holy, for my sister to live holy, me myself, I find it easier to live holily. You know, those places where I don't dress well, where I don't carry yourself well, where women will dress semi-naked into the church, they are creating an environment of defilement for the brothers. And what you say is what you have as well. And as they are doing that, they say, my mind is me, my mind is pure, I don't have any negative intention. But as they are creating an environment of defilement, they themselves are getting more and more defiled. And I'm begging you, I'm pleading with you, and God also is pleading with all and sundry, that let's create an environment of holiness for this church. That the pulpit will make it easy for the pew to be holy. The pew make it easy for the pulpit to be holy. And I gave a number of illustrations, and I left then. I come to holiness and humility. That is a combination, that we want to be humble and be holy at the same time. That some people are proud and they are saying they are holy. May I even tell that humility is the beginning of holiness? Are you aware of that? Because if you feel that you have arrived, you won't ask for sanctification, you ask for purity, you won't ask for the second work of grace, you won't see anything good in yourself. And I even told you then that Isaiah was a man who was a prophet, prophesying and preaching and declaring the mind of God. He wasn't preaching heresy, he was preaching the truth. And he will say, woe unto you that are strong to be mean, that are mighty to me to be struggling. Woe unto you that are doing this, woe unto you that are doing this, woe unto you that are doing this. And he was declaring woe. Several woes, not four, not five, not six, many woes, until he had an experience, and that experience tonight, all of you will have it.
Amen.
And in that day, that year, that King Uzziah died, he saw a vision, and the vision transformed him. He had been saying woe to everybody before, but now there's a time to look inward. And God has brought me here, this program, to look inward, to rest and come apart and come aside and come awhile, to look inward. You'll be inviting people unto holiness. You'll be preaching the colonia. You'll be teaching the side scripture. You'll be preaching on the pulpit. You'll be doing things in maybe there in the hostel. And you'll be doing wonderful things. It's now time to stop and look inward. And when King Uzziah died, he said, I saw also the Lord. About him stood the seraphim. And he described the vision. And eventually, when he saw the vision of God, and I saw the holiness of God, and I compared the holiness of God with some holiness. You know, sometimes you don't know how defiled you are, how dirty you are, until you bring your dirty cloth beside a clean cloth. Am I right? And you compare together. And I could now see the vision of the Almighty, how holy he is. is and how defiled he is. I compared his own righteousness with the expected righteousness. He compared his own displayed righteousness with the required righteousness. He said, enough of woe to other people. Now woe is unto me. He confessed. And when God saw that, yes, now he has realized his state, then what the seraphim came and took now a coal of fire from the altar and poured his lips and said, lo, now this has touched your lips, your iniquity is purged and your sin pardon. That voice tonight, you will all hear it. I said, you will all hear it. And when that experience became the experience of Isaiah, then he was ready for a commissioning. And he said, God now said, whom shall I send? Who will now go for him? Me. Who will now go for me? And he said, here I am, send me. And God is looking for people to send, but holy people must be sent. And he found that in you, in Jesus' name. Now let that now come to experiencing holiness. Because if I be talking about holiness and humility, talking about environment of holiness, then we must also talk about how to express it indeed. And I then gave an illustration of a song in the book of Deuteronomy 21, Deuteronomy 21, and in verse 18, Deuteronomy 21, and in verse 18, I have to explain holiness, how it must be experienced. Deuteronomy 21, everybody from the Bible now, and in verse 18, are you there, everybody? Are you there, everybody? 21, 18, maybe I should wait for you now. Deuteronomy 21, don't be tired of opening your Bible. 21, now in verse 18. Are you there, everybody, now? If a man have a stubborn, a rebellious son, don't forget, I said that time, that you all have rebellious and stubborn hearts. Even though you are saved, after salvation, there's still this rebellious and stubborn son in heart. If a man have a stubborn and a rebellious son, which will not obey the voice of his father, or the voice of his mother, and that when they have chastened him, he will not hearken unto them. What can better describe an unsanctified heart than this verse? What can better describe an unsanctified heart with this passage of scripture? You see, the heart is like a son. The son belongs to the father, belongs to the mother. The heart also belongs unto you. And the son is living in the same house with the father and with the mother. The heart also lives in the same habitation with you. The son, the heart is in the inside of you. But unfortunately, the heart is stubborn. The son is stubborn. And so the heart also is stubborn. You know that thing is you that you don't want to just easily obey. Something is kicking in the inside of you. That's this kind of unforgiveness in you. That's this kind of lusting in you. That's this kind of bitterness in you. Kind of envy in you. That if you are possible to display your thought on the screen, you will feel ashamed what is going on in your mind. And in fact, some of these things, you don't want them to be there at all. You are struggling with it. Sometimes you say, Satan, I bind you. But then the thought continues. Sometimes you say, I call myself the brother Jesus Christ. Yet the thought continues. And you are struggling. Something is always going on there that you don't appreciate, that you don't want. It's a stubborn son. It's a stubborn heart. It's in the inside of you. It's in your chest. Which will not obey. It will not obey you. You don't want unclean thought, but it's going on there. You don't want unholy thought, but it's continuing. And you will not obey the voice of his mother, and that when they have sustained him, even when you bind and you rebuild, that's if he is still continuing, he may stay for a while, he continues again. You will not hearken unto them. Verse 19, then says his father. That is now the responsibility of the father and the mother. And that is now your own responsibility as well. The father and the mother shall lay hold on him. They call it to lay hold on your heart this evening, God will give unto you. Amen. Your amen is going cold. And bring him out unto the elders of his city, out of the gate of his place. And they shall say unto the elders of his city, this our son is stubborn and rebellious, and will not obey our voice. He is a glutton and a drunkard. That what will bring the son. It's not the elders looking around for the son. It will be by voluntary presentation. That's what we call consecration in theology. That is on your own, that you bring yourself onto the altar. They will lay hold on the son. Nobody has said the son for them. They will have to arrest the son and take the son out of the city and go and meet the head of the guy and say, this is our son, it's terrible. is glutton, is a drunkard, is stubborn, is not obedient, is incorrigible. Have him there, and if we correct him, he won't hear. We rebuke him, he won't change. That is our, and you go and present the son there. The same thing you want to do at sanctification. For your experiences, but you have to bring your heart unto God and say, this is how I am, this is my thought, this is my imagination, this is my reaction. Someone offended me, even though he came to apologize, I don't have to do what with me to forgive. And I want to forgive, but it's impossible, it's difficult for me. It's a stubborn heart, and you bring that unto the elders of the city. That's what they told you then, that God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, they are the elders. Because Christ also, that my sanctified people suffer the way are without the gate, that we should now bear to the post and go and meet him there. As they take the Son to the gate, take your heart also from within and go. Bear the repose. Forget about the shame and go unto God. Confess. As the parents will get there and say, he's about son. He's bad. He's terrible. You won't get there and keep quiet. As I was not quiet, he got there, he said, woe is unto me. Am I right? I dwell in the midst of people from plain lips. And me too, I'm a man from plain lips. I'm not different from the people I'm preaching unto. Therefore, change me. And he confessed. And something happened. Tonight also, as you confess, something will happen. And something will happen. And the same thing, and so the press will come and they will confess. And as they do that, you know what will happen? The whole city will stone the son, and the son will die. Evil heart in you will die tonight. I said, will die tonight. You know that song says, oh, purge me down, will die within, or purge with fire. If that must be, no matter how, if only sin will do what? Doubt in me. Tonight, it will have to somebody with doubt in you in Jesus' name. So that is what we speak with me. With the kind of thing we discuss, even before we arrive, we talk about experience of holiness. And we give different things about holiness. And now tonight, so I talk and I climax and I conclude the series. I'm talking on illustrations of holiness. Illustrations of holiness. And you know, there have been things that in the scriptures that you can use to describe and illustrate holiness to make you more practical, more real, more acceptable, more appreciable, that you can learn to find it easier to obtain. Why are we teaching all of this? We are teaching that both the Christian and the people we are preaching onto can lay hold on the experience and appropriate same to their life. It shouldn't be just swell our knowledge, just increase our theology, just enhance our vocabulary. No, it is to lift us up from where you are and relocate us to where we have never been. And that will happen to us tonight in Jesus' name. And we say it will happen in Jesus' name. And so we are illustrating holiness even tonight. But before I go to the Bible, let me tell you some things in the physical. Someone put it this way. Say, it's like an individual fell into a dish. And the dish of dirty waters. And everybody started running all around. And the fire brigade people now came around. And people around will not just want to rescue life. Because if you are forced into a well, it will die of suffocation. Am I right? Yes. And so if someone now forced into a well right here, both his friends and even his acquaintances and those who don't even know him at all will be on the scatter. Everybody will be struggling. So he will go and remove leather. So he will be phoning the fire brigade people. So everybody will just be doing one thing or another to just lift him out. And it happened to a man, he fell into a dirty dish. And there he has drunk dirty water, filled up, and the belly has protruded. And they now managed to rescue him and bring him out. And eventually he was rescued, he was brought out. But someone now said, this man you have helped, even though he left the dish and was rescued the dish, he didn't die inside the dish. But except we do something quickly, he didn't die inside the dish, he died outside the dish. That's like sanctification. When you are saved, you are taken out of sin. God lifts you out of unrighteousness. You are before inside sin, baptized into sin, immersed into sin. So wallowing in sin, swimming in sin. But now something happened. Maybe you hear us preaching. Maybe the Holy Ghost has directly convicted you. And you pray and something happened. And now you are converted. And you prayed, you now repent of your sin, and God took away your sin. Lying no longer. Cheating in examination no longer, fighting no longer, and quarreling no longer. You don't fight any longer, no masturbation any longer, no boyfriend any longer, no girlfriend any longer. Now you are out of the dish. Thank God for that. That's initial rescue. But if you do, you don't do anything suddenly, the day you didn't die inside sin, you will die it outside sin. And so he said something must be done for that man. So we have to do another rescue. So then they will have to sit down. You know what they do to such people? They will begin to press their tummy. Am I right? The dirty water inside of there need to gush out from different outlets, some through the ear, some through the mouth, some through the nostrils. And eventually then he poured them out. That he, even though he didn't die in the geese, now he may not be able to breathe because water has covered everywhere now. In the inside of him, no space for the air. And so they now poured him out, then he's free and free. I think he'll be free indeed. Amen. Well, if the Son of Man shall set you free, ye shall be free indeed. That is holy, that's sanctification. That even though you have, you didn't die in sin, can still die and be condemned outside of sin. But there's a sin inside you. Even though it's not outside you now, but it's in the inside of you, whether outside or inside. Bible say, I condemn you not, but go and sin no more. That one you hear tonight. Amen. And we've walked through your life in Jesus' name. Amen. And that is what we are talking about. That's illustrating holiness. Again, it's like this. If I've been to the lagoon before in Lagos, I need to watch them sometimes. You know, those olden days, we just go to the, when they have dazed you, that's our language in our undergraduate days. When you say this test, you didn't do well. You say this test, you didn't do well. This test, and that one is tomorrow morning. And everything, and you have not read the five percent of the thing, and if you read the first 2 pages, it's not even clear at all. And you know what you do? Don't go and sit there by the side of the lagoon. That's some breeze that you won't be coming there. You won't die here. You won't be looking around and saying, when you have, we say that 1 hour twice there, you continue yourself and you live again. The struggle continues. I go and start reading again. And so now when you sit there, you see those people. And you see them, the fishermen, fisherwomen. See them, now they have done a bridge. That time, that political military bridge was not there then. And so you don't see any bridge at the back of the university then, there in Lagos. But you, what will now happen is that you don't see those other people, those women, they just come. And strangely, you won't see any boat before. But they knew where they were keeping the boat. The boat will be inside the river. They don't keep their boat at the back of the river. They will go there, pull out something, and then before you know what is happening, a new boat is on the river, and they are over the boats. They can't be before underneath. That's like you. You are before hidden in sin. We didn't see you in the kingdom. We didn't recognize you in the kingdom. We don't know you in the kingdom. Now you are there as you are not there. But now you are before under the water, but now above the water. That's like salvation. You are taken out of sin, now over and above sin. And they will not be climbing, and they will not be driving. And just now before was not riding on you. But now you are over the water. You are now over the water of sin. And it's not the one sailing, riding on you. It's not that directing your boat. But you know something? Something good will happen. Those people, they be continually be doing something. Because it's just a boat that you paddle with just a canoe. What happened that water will be coming in gradually. What are they coming like? Have you seen that one before? And they have a small container. They be using to pour the water little by little. Before you know what is happening. If guys not take it, if they continue like that without begin to pour the water, just take it a little, throw it away. After regular times, the water will get tired. Will now sink the boat itself. The same thing. The sin in the inside of you that you are lying gradually is coming. Nothing is coming gradually. Is there? And the impurity is coming gradually is there. Bitter is coming gradually is there. One day, loss will give back to sin, give back to masturbation, give back to immorality, give back to fornication, give back to going to the brutal. And it will be strange to you what you even find yourself doing. Why? Because sin is coming gradually, and you are doing nothing about it. I pray tonight you will do something about it. I say you will do something about it. I say you do something about it. And I gave you then a number of illustrations. I told you also about scripture talking about the temple compartments. That the holy place. Everybody can come in there. Am I right? That the holy place. The outer court. Everybody can come in there. The holy place for me and for you. And that's for the priests and the Levites. The holiest of the holies. Holy Ghost baptism. Third experience. Salvation, sanctification, and the Holy Ghost. You will be in the holy place. Amen. Many people today are just in the outer court. They can't come inside. But as you come today to Calvary, you will come boldly and be able to enter. And there will be no fear again in the inside of you. Because perfect love will be in your heart and you cast away fear. They will say rapture will soon happen. You will be joyous. Some people are saved and yet they are afraid of rapture. Some people are saved and yet they are afraid of death. Some people are saved and yet they are afraid of judgment. But tonight, as you come boldly into his presence, that boldness will continue in you. Because you'll be holy through and through, you'll be holy within and without, and God will pour you thoroughly in Jesus' name. What about the Noah's Ark? Actually, it had 3 layers. The first layer, the second layer, the third layer. Maybe you are just in the first layer now. God will lift you up. You're in your own layer. You're in your own level. And we move higher unto holiness in Jesus' name. Now today we come to the illustration from scripture. And may I mind you, for some time I have not been talking about 3 points. Are you aware of that? So if I were waiting for 3 points, you'll be disappointed tonight. You better quickly wait for what you get from the word of God and really pray to God will help you in Jesus' name. Book of Malachi 3. Malachi, start 3. From verse 1 to 3. Malachi 3. From verse 1. Malachi chapter 3. Read with me from verse 1. Malachi 3 from verse 1. Behold, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me. And the Lord whom ye seek shall suddenly come to his temple. Even the messenger of the covenant whom ye delight in. Behold, he shall come in, saith the Lord of hosts, but will abide the day of his coming. I shall stand when he appeareth. For he is like a refiner's fire and like fuller's soup. And he shall see it as a refiner. He will refine you. And purify of silver. And he shall purify the sons of Levi, the workers. And put them as gold and silver, that they may offer to the Lord an offering. How? That we offer offering righteousness. Lord, this looks like a prophecy. I will still come back to this passage, but I will take you to part of the fulfillment. Sometimes a singular prophecy in the Bible has multiple fulfillment. I will take you to part some of the fulfillment in scripture in the book of Matthew or John, please, start 2. John, to start with, start 2. Read with me there now in verse 21. John 2, in verse 21. John, start 2. Read with me in verse 21. John, chapter 2. Come to verse 13. And the Jews' Passover was at hand. And Jesus went up to Jerusalem and found where? And found where? Gold and sold oxen and sheep and doves and the singers of mourning sitting. That's not what he was saying. And the messenger of the covenant shall suddenly come to his temple. That makes sanctification a definite experience. Suddenly, when something happens immediately, when something happens suddenly, when it doesn't happen in beats, we say it is definite. Am I right? So if he comes suddenly to his temple, that makes sanctification definite. And now he has come into his temple. And how did he come now? He came suddenly. He didn't come gradually. And you know, arriving at a place gradually. He come there suddenly. And so he did a work of purification, of sanctification in the temple. As we come here tonight by the temple of the living God, here tonight we purify you. Amen. I say we purify you. Amen. But it will come suddenly, and here now it came suddenly and find in the temple. Not it can find in you all those thoughts going on in your heart. Pastor may not see it. Someone sitting down by you may not see it. Your squatter may not see it. Because I sleep on the same bed, may not see it. As small as your bed, your bed is, they are sleeping together. You may not even see what is going on in your heart, but you found Christ could see. And that is why we take it so seriously. Many times we are only concerned what the sin we commit and others see. But we are not concerned about God seeing and he found in the temple. And when God will look at you, you will find nothing amiss in you. And he found in the temple those that sold oxen and sheep and doves. You know what was happening then? It was a time of Passover. Passover was at hand. And people come from the different part of the nations to come and worship. And when they come now, they will come with their doves. Come with their oxen. Come with their sheep. And sometimes when they come there, those other people, they want to make merchandise of them. They say, look, your oxen is old. See, it has come from a long distance and now it's tired. It's unhealthy, it's sick. Is it what you want to offer to God? Better come and buy here. Go and buy that. Your offering will not be acceptable. And there are all sorts of shady things. That's like your heart. Your heart, they are not pure. They are not sincere. When you say some things, it's 50% true, 50% false. We can't say you are telling lie all the same, but you're not saying the whole truth all the same. That's like you. And they will be as if they are only serving God. They want the best for me, for the Lord. But it's not because they want to sell. What they want to sell? Say, go and dispose it. And the money you are bringing, the idol of your nation is inscribed on it. We don't take that kind of idol. God will not take that kind of money in the temple. Come and change your money here. And so there are money changers there. There are sellers of doves, of oxen, of sheep, right there in the temple, and all selling. And they've forgotten the essence of the temple. It's now becoming a den of thieves and a place of merchandise, a place of buying and selling. That was what was happening there. And Christ got there. That's like your heart. When selling is going on in the place, there is a giving out. Am I right? Answer me now. And I say taking in. Am I right? Your heart is always giving something out. It's giving out virtue. It's giving away grace. Immoral thought is coming in. You are selling, you are trading your heart, the seal of your heart, for unholiness, for bitterness, for envy, for wrangling, for jealousy, for struggling, for scheming, for supplanting, for hypocrisy. And that is going out of you. You are giving away grace, you are taking in all of those. There's buying and selling in your heart. And Christ now comes and he fasts all of those. He now gives something. What if he did here me tonight, he will give for you as well. Now in verse 13, in verse 14. And find in the temple those that sold oxen and sheep and those and the changers of money sittings. And we had made a scourge of small corn. That is word. Sanctify them by your word. The word of God drives out evil. That's out fear, that's out lusting, that's out immorality, that's out impurity, that's out dirty thought, that's out unforgiving, that's out bitterness. And in his call of small calls, he drove them all out of the temple, and the sheep and the oxen, and poured out the singer's money, and do what now? And overthrew what? The tables. The table is a place of activity. When you see anybody bringing up a table anywhere, it's an activity, it's about starting. Am I right? Table is not meant for decoration. So that you are writing on the table or you are sitting on the table, something will just begin on. All those evil activity going on in your heart tonight, God will overthrow the table of your spirit and holy thought will continue the years from now onward in Jesus' name. And so he overthrew the table. He didn't only send them out, he had the intention that they won't continue any longer. He sent them away, he discontinued the activity and threw it away. Tonight, he discontinued his activity. And when he did that now, and said unto them that stole those, take these things hence. And that's what we tell God even tonight. Take this evil heart from hence. Take unholy from hence. Make not my father's house what? An house of merchandise. Now, and he did that. And what he did, he will do for me again in Jesus. Come back to Malachi 3. Malachi 3. Now in verse 1. Malachi 3. Read with me there in verse 1. We now see the prophecy that we read here and now see the fulfillment. Malachi 3. Read with me now in verse 1. Behold, I will send my messenger and he shall prepare the way before me. And the Lord whom you see. If I can do it, you must seek him first of all. You don't desire sanctification, it will not happen. The Lord whom ye seek, that will be the desire of righteousness. Blessed are they that task after righteousness. What will happen? It shall be filled. You don't task after it tonight, you won't get it. And you have it already, you can't get it too much. You can be more holy than the way you have been. It's definite and also progressive. Definitely saying that we enter into it and become holy. But again, it keeps growing as well. You grow in it. Not grow into it, but you grow in the inside of holiness. And now, love whom you seek. Now, shall suddenly come into his temple. Even the messenger of the covenant, whom you delight in. Number one, seek him. Number two, delight in. Still say the same thing. And behold, he shall come. And he will come tonight. He will come tonight. Behold, he shall come. See the Lord of hosts. But whom may I buy? When he came, they were running away. Am I right? Answer me now. But who they abide? The day of his coming. When he came, even he alone, healthy men were running away. Even him alone, women that were there, they were running away. Everybody were running away. He was on the table, they were not challenging him. And he alone, he came. They couldn't abide the day of his coming. All those evil things in your heart, as they come, they won't stay. The world you mean. Who may abide the day of his coming? And who shall stand when he appeareth? For he is like a refiner's fire and like fuller's soap. The fire of holiness will burn in the inside of you. Amen. I said it will burn in the inside of you. Amen. I said he will not only come, he will also sit there. And God will continue to sit there. He will do perfectly in the inside of you tonight in Jesus' name. Amen. Yes. Listen to me. The local government people, they don't understand what we're talking about. Sometimes they will say, no selling here. I've seen that one before. And they will say, no, we don't want to any market here. And they will say, send all those women away. And they will come, maybe policemen or other people, law enforcement agents. And they will just come one day and begin to play with me bridge and push away people. Even they will carry some of them to their station. You go and bury your party will be with money in the station. And they will crawl out, just sit away. And everybody, they will run away. If they go away, I don't come for about 1 week. What do you think will happen? As I mean now, they will come back there. Am I right? That's like you. You were sanctified last year. But God will do something about it. The table had been overthrown. The dough that had been sent away. The altar, the seat that are gone. Now they are coming back. That is why tonight, don't be proud. Don't cover your holiness with garment of spirituality. Those that have come back, let God bring them out again. That's not be a retreat to Calvary. And the God is still waiting at Calvary. Do you know that this purification of the temple, he did it twice. The one I show you now was the first one. I will now show you the second one. Because when I done it again, did it before, and what he has done, our people have been undone. He will come back again and redo it again. Tonight, he will come back to your heart and he will do it again. And keep now where he did it in the book of Matthew 21, verse 12. Matthew 21, look with me in verse 12. Matthew 21, now in verse 12. Are you there, everybody? Read your Bible, open your Bible. Matthew 21. In verse 12, and Jesus went to the temple. The one that was before was around Passover time. The same anniversary now, this happened here. But this one happened after the triumphal entry. And now, Jesus went to the temple of God and cast out all them. Nothing will remain tonight. You say, I'm sanctified. Look, as we have, I love God. No loss in my heart, no bitterness, no envy, nothing whatsoever. The only thing that remains is this anger. God said that he cast them all out, and tonight all of them will be cast out. And cast out all them that sold and bought the temple and overkill the tables of the money changer. The same thing is doing all over again. This was not a parallel passage, it was another event. And over the table of the money changers, and the seeds of them that sold those, and said to them, it is written that I promise of God for sanctification. My house shall be called the house of prayer. But he said, you have made it what? A den of thieves. And when he said all of those ones, they all ran away. And nothing remained. Tonight, nothing will remain. It has gone before, now it has come back. You have to do the whole work all over again tonight. And as you're doing this whole work all over again, there will be a new experience. Amen. A new holiness. A new sanctification. And then when it happens, you don't have to say that I'm pastor, I'm priest, I'm GC, I'm coordinator, I'm all that, I'm anything. No. You come, when you get to heaven, on the pier's gates, the title of pastor will disappear. That of DC will disappear. That of horror will disappear. No matter what you are, that will disappear. If you be only you are your testimony of righteousness and holiness before God. That's why when you come tonight, forget whom you are. Come boldly to the throne of grace and abide yourself unto me. Go to that gate and meet the elders and abide yourself before them. And just say, here I am. You've done it before. You have to do it again. Woe is unto me, I'm a man of unclean lips. I dread the misery of me, the misery of the people who are unclean lips. Therefore, forget my past righteousness. All this fake sanctification. All this false sanctification, all this counterfeit sanctification, all this paper, calendar sanctification that we are still filling to the form. All those who forget them. Maybe you feel them in good ordination. That's not the issue now. But now, the one that will take you to heaven, one that other one will fetch you ordination. This one will fetch you the rapture. The one to fetch you the rapture is the real thing. Seek after it, pursue it, get it. Then your service will be acceptable and you'll be ready for heaven. And God will be ready for heaven in Jesus' name. Listen, something happened just last 2 years or last year. I happen in his church, in a CAC. I'm making a CAC not to deride them. What happened then, all can happen here. See, it's not the issue of, I don't discredit anyway, and just anyhow. I don't talk that way. I'm saying them so that you can know the criticality and reality of what I'm talking about. And now one of them died. I know that was a problem sometimes. They had different divisions and different groups. Are you aware of that? And they were even in the court at the time. But now I think that one was over. But I have seen some little groups among them. One of the leaders, if I mention the name, you know the person, died. And as he died, he got away. He went away. And just at the at the gate of Peel, he was about entering. Then the offender
was there and he came out.
And he said that this other person that the people are left behind, I've not been seen there. He mentioned the name of so and so. I've not seen him. So and so. And the person had died recently. They said they have gone. No. I didn't see them. I didn't see any of them. I mean, I'm not saying that all of the leaders that have died have not got to heaven. But the people that he mentioned, that's the people that what I'm talking about now. Not all the leaders that have died. Others will be, I'm sure some of them will be in heaven now. But the ones the people he mentioned, they were in there. And the man was saying, no, they've gone. He said, I can't find them. And like, even you yourself, you see your garment. The way you are, you can't enter here. See the fragment all around on your garment. You can't enter. It's not possible. But God had mercy. The man came back. And when he woke up, he was weeping. And now he was pleading. And he was now telling the story. What I'm talking about, holiness is a reality. It's an issue. What is it? Instead of being a pastor, being a DC, or being a holder, it's a good thing that we are here together, relating together, we're happy together. A pastor is coming, Jesus is coming, everybody, and we are happy together. People will still come back from home. It's a good thing. That's a fellowship here on earth. Can you imagine a fellowship in heaven? How it will be? And because of the prayer you want to pray, every 30 minutes prayer, maybe it's a meditation that you do, maybe it's a that you should settle, or the things you just do that you don't take not enough time, as you even make you happy here on earth, and make you ready for heaven, and you refuse to do it, just because you just want to be careless, just because you don't take it very, very seriously, and eventually it compares sounds, or there's death, or anything happen, and now lost for eternity, lost forever. That may be the person in Jesus' name. That is why he's now come to his temple. And it's now what to see that is the furnace fire. And it is full of soul and to purge you. And then your offering shall not be acceptable unto him. And you'll be prepared for heaven. If any man be ready for this, heaven is also ready. There's Calvary there, a new touch. You had it before, you can have it again. Sanctify the people, O God, and the people will be holy. That's why let us pray. Why don't you tell God tonight, my okay will be like that. They will not be forgiven for me in heaven and find a mission. I will not be absent in heaven. I will not be absent in heaven. What must happen. I will not be found missing. What must happen. What need be done must be done. I will not be found absent. I will not be found missing. When the road is called up yonder, I will be there. I will not be absent. I will not be missing. They will find me. They will find me. We are looking at the bush and they are turning it over. My name will be there. They will find me. Restitution will not hinder me. The fire will not hinder me. Jealousy will not hinder me. Envy will not hinder me. Hatred will not hinder me. Pride will not hinder me. Immorality will not hinder me. Masturbation will not hinder me. Nothing will hinder me. Hatred of people. All forgiving spirit will not hinder me. I will be there. Now I've illustrated to you of what holiness will be should be. What against the idea that I've not done? Now be holy. God said, send for the people of God. And then we be holy. Yes, Christ comes. Jesus and my son is people. Suffer without the gate. And now let's be at the post. Go to him there and meet him and find him. And then experience the holiness. Pray unto God right now. Pray unto him. My house shall be a house of prayer. My house shall be a house of prayer. My house shall be a house of prayer. Is your heart and a continuous altar of prayer? Is holiness in the inside of you? Are you pure within? Purge me down without within. Wash me down without within. All come with fire. He that must be. No matter what happens, not anyhow. If only say, doubt in me. Pray, thank God. Let's doubt in me. Sisters, you can't stay together and see eye to eye. You'll be certainly calling all the time. Have you been in heaven? Have you get to heaven with that kind of attitude? Will you be in heaven with that kind of attitude? Let's send doubt in me. 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 Don't let it down. Don't play it down. Don't pick it in my prayer. I battle myself in his presence. It's time for holiness. On the people we are praying. Sisters are praying. Brothers are praying. All of us are praying together. We want nothing but holiness. Make us holy, God. Sanctify the souls. Sanctify the people. Sanctify the preacher. Sanctify the pastor. Sanctify the members. Sanctify the workers. Sanctify the leaders. Sanctify the executives. Sanctify the coordinators. Sanctify everybody, oh God. Holiness of heart. Look for hindrance.
not to serve you here on the earth and go to hell. We want to get to heaven. Send us all together, oh God. Pray more.
The Lord whom you seek,
so we come to his temple. Let's come boldly to the throne of grace and receive mercy. And find grace to help in time of need. We have not a high prayer recorded by the feeling of our vanities, but we're now what as we are. Come unto him now. Come unto him now. Come unto him now. It's time for holiness. We have a holy source, holy pulpit, holy pew. We are holy in the room. We are holding the closet. We are holding at home. We are holding on the campus. We are holding the classroom. We are holding the source. We are holding the vehicle. We are holding everywhere. They were ready for heaven.